Hello everyone, today I'm going to show you about polar cosine series. Polar cosine series is a picture of continued form of the malformation characterized by the law of differentiation and midline cleavage of cephalon. Traditionally divided into bilobar, semilobar, and lobar subtype. Middle interhemispheric variant syncellular encephaly is generally accepted as subtype holoprosencephaly. Cephaly. More common signs and symptoms. Clinical presentation depends on severity of malformation. Hollow eight lobar holoprosencephaly present at birth with facial dysmorphism, macrocephaly or microcephaly. Seizure. Most affected neonates are stillborn or have very short lifespan. Semilobar holoprosencephaly present with epilepsy, movement disorder, developmental delay, facial anomaly are mild or absent. Lobar holoprosencephaly present with mild moderate developmental delay, hypothalamic pituitary dysfunction, visual problem. Middle interhemispheric form presented with moderate connective impairment, ventricular spasticity, mild visual impairment, hypothalamic function is normal. Other signs symptoms associated with non-cranial facial anomaly, genital defect, postaxial polydactyly, vertebral defect, limb abduction defect, transposition of great vessel. Imaging, abnormal midline communication of gray and white matter. Category represent continent of foreground malformation without clear distinction between subtype. If lobar holoprosencephaly, complete absence of cleavage with pancreas of interior cerebral tissue, presence of interior monoventricular communicating with blood processes through stomach. Semilobar holoprosencephaly, interhemispheric fissure and cleft, cerebral form posteriorly with absence of frontal lobe separation and varying degree of failed B-encephalon cleavage. Lobar holoprosencephaly subventricular is fully formed. The encephalon separation, interhemispheric fissure and valves are mostly formed with absent cleavage in inferior frontal MIH, lack of posterior frontal and parietal midline separation with cleavage of anterior frontal and occipital lobe. Genetic seizures in this case, this is the axial T1 frontal and 40 or with lobar holoprosencephaly, so a more non-ventricular and a dorsal cyst that displaced the brain anteriorly. in a pancake configuration, not the normal lake of myelinization of the cerebral vibrator and disabled. This is the axial T1 MR in a 6-year-old with semi-lobar hollow prosencephaly, so non-separation of the frontal lobe and anterior caudate nucleus. However, there is separation of the parietal and occipital lobe. It partially identified posteriorly. This is non-contrast CT, demonstrated a thin rim of cerebral tissue anteriorly without midline cleft. This aligned sense of density space posteriorly. There is no evidence of profound cerebri. The cerebrum is malformed with abnormal occurrence of both vertical brainstem is visible. And this is the axial non-contrast CT of brain. Demonstrate hoof shoes frontal lobe with absent interior part of the cerebellum. There is also absence of the septum pellucidum with shoes of the lateral ventricle with rudimentary occipital and temporal horn with a prominent dorsal cyst. And this is the intrauterine ultrasound finding of fetal head and face include a moment a monoventricular cavity of CSF with absent midline structure, high corpus callosum and false cerebri, thalamic nuxus, some residual peripheral ring of brain tissue is known. The brainstem and cerebrum are normal. The midline cleft lip and hypotelorism can also be appreciated. Treatment, seizure control, hormone replacement. Thank you.